Schumann, the way Schumann and I worked, and we sat down at the piano. Schumann played piano, played a little guitar. He wrote about 75% of the melody and about 25% of the lyric. So it was a true collaboration. You know, probably my most successful song commercially, financially, was Save the Last Dance for Me. And like many other songs that I've written, it had been rejected a lot of places. Well, finally, the Drifters had recorded it. And usually at a Drifters session that was produced by Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller, we don't even have songs in the session because Jerry and Mike never wrote much. And with Save the Last Dance, we didn't know what was going to happen with it, so we were rehearsing it with Jimmy Clint. And Jimmy Clint was about to record the song when we got a call. The next Drifters record was about to be released, and Mort Schumann and myself had both sides of the record. And they said that Save the Last Dance was the B-side. Now, we thought Save the Last Dance was the B-side. And what had happened, they ran with the other side, Atlantic, and when they brought it over to Dick Clark to start playing with it, Dick Clark told them that they were on the wrong side. He was right, they turned it over. And you know, it's conceivable that if they never turned it over, Save the Last Dance could have been another B song that died out there. I told Jimmy Clinton that I had a substitute for him, a song called Go Jimmy Go. So you're lucky you got a couple of hits out of it.
Well, I talked her off the floor when she said, go Jimmy, go.
Say the last dance.